Hello students, welcome back to my channel. I am teacher Sarita. Today I am going to teach chapter number 2 of class 3, Environmental Science. Let's begin. Can you tell some question you have to answer? You will easily recognize the animal in the picture. Tell their names and also their special feature. You have to recognize. This is manna, bird, this is a bird. And this is parrot, it's also bird. This is your deer, then this is snake, okay, and elephant, sparrow, bird, manna. These all are birds. So what they do? They fly in the air, in the sky, okay. This is deer. They walk on land, animal. This is reptile, snake. They crawl on the ground. And this is elephant, they walk on the ground. And this is big, okay. And these birds are small, it is little bigger than the bird, then this is little, then this smaller, okay. These all are the special features. Now next you come down again. Can you tell is here? So you can see the question. Can you tell animals that fly in the sky, animals that live in water? The animals that fly in the sky, that are birds. An animal that live in water, that is called aquatic animals, okay. The animals that are black, animals that have many color. Animals that are black, black color you have to name. Crow is there. And animals that have bear is there. Animals that have many colors mean different birds that come in the category of birds. Chameleons, gyrgit, that we change the color according to the surrounding to protect themselves or to hunt the prey. Very large animals, you know that elephant, which live on the ground, and whale, which is in the water, which is the largest than the elephant. Very tiny, small ant, mosquito. So these you have to write them, which I will give you afterwards when the question answer starts. Now come down. Where, see this, where will you find us? They are asking, where will you find us? Okay, this is the picture. This is eagle, okay. Eagle, it is coming down to catch his prey. And this is your cow, they give us milk, okay. This is fish in the living in the water. First question, eagle flies high in the sky, yeah. So this is a bird. Where will you find bird? Trees, okay. A cow walks on the ground. It is the ground where you will shed or in some streets, etc. Fish swim in water. Where will you find us? So they live in the water, so normally you can find us inside the water, that is sea, river, lake, okay. So this page number 2, come to the page number 2. See this, so this is the page number 2. We are of different colors. So this is the, see, this is your crane, okay, the white color, pure white bird. And this is buffalo, this is your black color. And this is your peacock, colorful peacock, have many colors. So they are beautiful peacock, colorful bird. So the egret is white, that is a crane or egret, same, that is a white color, both are white, that it is a egret. The crow is black, the crow is black. The buffalo too is black, but peacock has many different color. These are the some answers which what we read in that page number, next page number 7. So these answer you can write in that, but I will give you. We may be big, may be small. Some animals are big, some animals are small. That is what this chapter want to tell you. The horse, that horse is there, see, horse. Then and a bullock. Bullock is not there. The bullock means that bullock bigger than the buffalo, where big lump is on their body. That bullock is, both are large in size. Their size is large. The goat and the dog. Goat, you see here, this picture, goat. And the dog, normal size, medium size there, okay. Mouse and the squirrel, very small, smaller than the goat and dog. It's a squirrel, okay. Gilhari, they are smaller. So now this one very very smaller. This is cockroach and ant. These are insects. Insects are smaller than the animals and birds. The earthworm and cockroach are smaller till. Grants and ants are very tiny and move from the earthworm and cockroach. The small that you see na, in rice and all that small insect is their black color. They and ants are very very tiny. So this is the difference between the size of the different animals and birds. Now come down. Can you tell? Again, 1, 2, 3 questions are there. Which animals run very fast? Which animals move very slowly? Okay, run fast comes cheetah. Okay, and which animal? Which animals move very slowly? Tortoise, snail. You can write. In this it comes cheetah, tiger. You can run fast. I will give you answers. We move in different ways. A squirrel is a small animal. Guillory. It is very small. It is nimble. It climbs up a tree quickly, swiftly run among its branches. Means it is very very this. It run here and there, very active. You cannot catch him. It is very fast, moving here and there. Okay, so the squirrel is very small, but it is very active. So nimble means quick. So it is very quick. It run here and there. Okay, so this is the different ways of movement. Now come down to this one is elephant. Its body is very very huge and very very big, so he cannot run too fast. It walks slowly. The elephant's body is bulky. Yeah, bulky means very very weighty. Its legs are heavy and the legs are also heavy, so it is very difficult to keep steps. So it is only walk. It cannot run in a speed. It runs, but not that much in a great speed. Okay, because of its heavy body. Now deer having very thin lean body and legs are very thin, so deer run fast like cheetah. Deer has thin legs, it runs very fast. So this question answer you will get here. If frog's hind legs, that is backside leg, thahui jumping, see that leg, it help them to support. Okay, are long, they are very long. When he jump, his front two legs, that is hand type, it stretches. Okay, so that four hind legs are so long that it helpful in jumping very high and running fast. So it can easily hoop, jump and leap. Hoop means jumping, jump and leap means very long jump. Okay, so this is the difference. Now come to this next page. Can you tell? Again, questions is there. Why do we keep crows? Name some other animal that are useful to us. Cows. Why do we keep cows? So why do we keep cows? Cows give us milk. So we keep it for cow, for milk. And name some other animal that are useful to us. So name some other animals like buffalo also give us milk, goat also give us milk, and birds, hen, okay, they give us egg. So this is a sheep give us wool. So we domesticate them. Why do we not like it if there are mice or bed bug in our house? Because mice means your mouse. Okay, so mouse and mice are very very troublesome. They just bite your clothes, bite your papers and destruction, and they can make your disease also, plague. And if they bite you, it is poisonous also. So they are very harmful creature. And bed bug means in the bed, small like insect is there which suck your blood. Okay, so these are not good, they are pest, so they are harmful. We should not keep them. Now you can find the answer here. You find us useful. Some animal I told you, cow, buffalo give us milk, sheep give us wool, hen, another bird give us egg. These are useful for us, for eating, for wearing, okay, for drinking milk. People love to keep animal as a pet also, dog, because they entertain you, they give you love. So the dog guards our house. Now that came to dog, it give you love, entertain you, and it guards to you because they're a very faithful animal. Nobody will can enter without and your permission. It guards your house. People like to keep cat too. Cat also is there, is sweet. Okay, that is called, this is called pet animal. Dog, cat, the pet animal, parrot, pet animal. Cows, buffaloes, goat give us milk. They give us milk. Some people keep hen for egg. We get meat, milk, egg from the animal. We get meat, milk, and these all came from the, come from the animal. Now, bullocks help in with farm work. What do bullock do in farming? Kheti badi mein, all that. It is called farming. Okay, so it hitch it to cart, means it just pull your cart away and they can draw heavy burden. And this bullock also help in carrying the heavy loads from one place to another. Horses and donkeys too are used to carry burden. They also help. But they are helpful to you, but this thing what they are telling, carrying load, it is not good because we are forcefully making them to carry loads, okay, for us. So this is not good for them. For us it is beneficial. For them we are hurting them. We look after the animals we keep. See, we look after them. We have to look after carefully. If this animal giving to us something, so we should pamper him, give good food, everything, proper care. We feed them, we give food, we take off them when they are ill. We should take, and definitely we should take, because we should give them treatment like we give our friends. The animal we keep become very dear to us. The animal, whatever we keep, they are so innocent that they, we should give them love also. Okay, so next down, we the gate crashers. Gate crasher means which is pest means harmful. See, mouse, they're eating the grains, their teeth are, two teeth are so big in front of that mouth. And the spider also, spider is poisonous. If something smell urine or its blood flow on your skin, it become allergic. Okay, some animals enter our houses even though we do not want to them. Okay, they suddenly enter, lizard and all that. I have a phobia with the lizard, cockroach. So it get entered because they are irritating also. They sometimes cause mess and illness also, diseases. Mice, rat destroy the grains. Beside groaning other things in the house, it making here and there and snatching and destroying the things, eating the things. Sometimes we find bed bug in our house. They suck our blood that I told you, which we got in a bed. Spiders make cobweb in the house. They are poisonous also, and they may web which look dirty. Mosquitoes, fly, ants and cockroach are a nuisance. They are disturbance. Mosquito, cockroach, they spread diseases. Okay, they are not good. Even so, these troublesome animals too have an important place in nature. These animals also having some important place in nature. Some God has made them for purpose. So, okay, but it is sometimes create nuisance instead of giving importance. We have seen that animals around us can be grouped in different ways. So we can see it can be grouped small, big, good, nuisance animals, like that. It formed this group using our everyday observation. So what is it? What is studying? We formed according to we classified. However, when scientists classify animal, they look at more important characteristics of animal. Let us see how they do it. When the scientists classify, they look characteristics, the nose, their behavior, like that. So we can read in the chapter. When we keep on reading, we will come to know. We suckle our young. Means we suckle our young. What is that? The young one of animal like cow, dog, goat, rat grow up on their mother's milk. They drink like the mother's milk. See, the cow, baby, calf is drinking mother's milk. Dog also, human being also, same behavior. Means they drink their mother. This is called suckle, okay? These animals have four legs. They have four legs, this animal. They have hair on their back. Small hair is there. They have external ears. Means inside the ears. So they can
they can hear, but and their ears are very powerful also. Okay, now we come to know with all these features. Now we fly. What is that? Birds have only two legs. Birds have only two legs. They have two wings. They have two wings to fly. To fly with that. That wings they help wings help them to fly. Their body is covered with feathers, and their body is covered with small feathers. Okay, that is the feathers, the protection for the wind, cold like that, hot. These are differences in flying ability of different birds. There are differences in flying ability of different birds. Many some fly very speedily, some have very the speed landing. So the eagle can soar high into sky, fly very high, okay, and stay in the air for long time. An eagle have a specialty than other bird. It keep on flying in the air for many hours, okay. But the cock does not fly high. Cock does not fly. It just only hopping and fly, then come down soon too, and come down to see little hoop, leap, then come down. So it cannot fly. But cock does not fly high and comes down soon too. That's it. Now we come to that. We live in water. There are many different kinds of fish. Okay, water many big, small. Okay. They live in water. Fish have fins. Fins means small. See, the diagram is a fin. Small. This help in to movement in the water when they swim. They use their fins to move in water. There are scales on their fish body. Scales are there. Gills are there. The scale is used for their respiration, for the breathing. Do you know a fish has gills behind their ear? Fish use these gills to breathe in water. So this is the fish. You can see the fish, they have gills, that is their nose. They work as a nose. See this here, it opens when they need any breathing. When they want breathe, they opens and then it close. They it is act like a snow nose type. Okay, it is act like a nose. Now come to that. We creep and crawl, and we creep on the ground. Rengna we say na, that is called reptiles. Chameleons, that is cricket, who change its color according to the surrounding to protect themselves and to catch the prey. House lizards, that is one of my most irritating thing, phobia type this. And snakes also, I don't like it, are animals that crawl. This animal crawls. They have scales on their bodies too. They also having scales, okay. Chameleons and house lizard have four legs, but these legs are very short. And this short leg have to move faster on the wall. The snake does not have any leg at all. Snake does not have leg because they have to creep like that. So move fast like a swinging. So they do not have legs. Now next, we are called insects. Now insects. Butterfly have wings too, but we do not call them bird. See the one different. Butterfly also have wings, they fly, but these are not coming under the category of birds. Besides, they have six legs. Mostly insects features we ask to you write the six legs. That is the main thing difference between the insects, birds and animals. Animals which have six legs are called insects. See what I told you. So butterfly are having six legs, that is why it is called insect. Mosquito, housefly, means your makki, cockroach are insect too, because they have wings, little small wings, and they have six legs. Do you know? What do you know? Let's see. Bats have wings, but they do not have feather on their belly. See the difference. They also have wing, but they do not have feather. Young ones of bat feed on their mother. It also drink milk. See, this is a bird type, so it's a mammal because it drink milk of their mother. Such a different this mammal. Bats are not birds. We see bird because wing like crow, sparrow. They are not like that, parrot and crow. They are include in the group of cow, tiger. They include in the group of cow, that is called mammal. Because they are giving their drink, their mother's drink, and they also don't give egg. They directly lay there, they give birth to the young ones. Okay, so such a strange. So these scientists are made them categorize. After long study, they divided into various categories to so that we can study easily. Now use your brain power. Into which of the following group would you put the owl? Owl would you put the monitor lizard? Okay, then your lizard and the cat. See the group. This I will give you in the question answers. Cow, dog, and goat. Cow, dog, and goat. We suckle our young ones. So these animals are what we call mammals. We can write. I will tell you. Crow, sparrow, parrot. We fly. The bird, chameleon, house lizard, and snake that crawl. It's called your what you will call reptiles. This was all about a few animals we are similar with, but there are many. Okay, many in the animals more in the world. Only few little they in this lesson they given you, but there are many many animals and insects are there. There are a lot of differences in color, shapes, sizes of animal. There are differences in the way they move, place they live. Okay, they are different in size, shape, the movement, speed, all have differences. These differences that we see among the animal give rise a lot of variety in the animals. The varieties are there. The number of animals that live in the sea is also very large. If you explore the sea water, if you go inside for swimming, you can see various types of fishes, animals, insects, and plants inside there. It's like a space, okay, water space. There's a great variety among them too. It is very interesting to learn about all such animals. Do try to find out more about them when you are older. When you go to highest classes, try to find out more from net, internet, from your parents, etc. So what we read, I have explained you clearly. I hope you might understood. Thank you for watching my video. Subscribe it, share it, like it, and keep reading. In next video, I will give you the question answers. Bye. Take care.